Yeah, this is in for repair. It's a Magnavox. Console stereo. And the owner said that it had a couple problems. It was really staticky, and then the records wouldn't drop. Something doesn't look right with that. That maybe it is okay. I don't know. Check that out. And when he brought it, I noticed it was on 78. It was flipped over to the other side, and I said, well, you know. This is a solid state. Not much to it at all. No model number on it. Looks like it has an option for a tuner that's not there. Kind of see the power transformer. Let's fire it up and see what it does. Try a little Burt Bacharach here. All right. He said it wouldn't drop either. So I'm gonna drop it down. Geez, that sure seems heavy to me. Cut it out. The stylus isn't even Okay, there's plenty of sensitivity there. It's not like an amplifier problem. I think the needle's just gone. Exactly, there is no needle left. So that could be part of the problem. It might need that. In fact, I bet you the thing is laying down in here somewhere. Also, I wonder about this auto-dropping mechanism. Oh, yeah. All right, let me get a needle first, and then I will... Boy, is this hard. And then I will go from there. Okay, a package came from these guys. Radio TV Phone On Out likes these guys and recommends them. And I just simply emailed some pictures of this unit to... this guy Gary here, and he sent me the right needle, or else directed me on which one to order. And it fit right in. It looks the same, but the thing is not, does not sound like it's working right to me. Having a little bit of a hard time understanding this balance control. Usually balance goes from left to right. I don't get this at all. But anyway, we'll go back into the Burt Bacharach. And it's, that's the volume wide open. So the bass is doing absolutely nothing. I know it's sometimes the cameras don't pick up changes in bass, but it's not doing anything. Absolutely nothing. It almost sounds like maybe the ground from the cartridge. Maybe the cartridge is bad and I'm only... getting like left minus right, or the difference between the two. I mean, it sounds better. Sounds better coming off the needle almost. Let's do Pablo Cruz here. I don't know. It's not in stereo. There's something's missing. All right, well, I got the back off, and let's see what we got here. We got some wires hanging loose. They go up to the amp chassis. We got some wire nuts. Those are always a reassuring sign. And okay, let's get this thing down on a piece of carpet where we can what the left ground and what the so this speaker here is hooked up to left positive and right positive. And this speaker here is hooked up to left positive and ground. I imagine, I can't see this. Hold on, let me crawl up in here from here. We got one. One C and two, is that what that says? One. So this should be hooked up to here. It's a wrong size spade connector. Okay, let's see here. So this is going from there, that's correct, to the filter capacitor, or not the filter capacitor, the EQ capacitor. I mean, this thing should rock. Look at this, it's got two 12s and four of these little 4-inch mid. I wonder what this is. Oh, this is pilot light. Okay, and this is just dangling in here waiting to short out and burn something up. It's just, someone soldered that in there. It's supposed to be spade. Let's get rid of that. I don't want that shorting out on anything. And then we got left and right here from the turntable. Okay. All right, let's see if it sounds any better now. Okay, come on. Balance kind of does a little bit more now. You know what's fascinating is the gentleman that owns this was telling me how good it sounded before, I guess, the needle broke off. And let me see how to be like gentle with this. I guess we all have our definition of what sounds good and what something should sound like and its ability. It's like a lot of people will accept a crappy picture on an old color TV, and an old color TV should have a really stellar picture if it's working right. And this is not working right at all. This thing should light up the neighborhood with good, solid, full sound. All right, just in the interest of insanity, before I go any further pulling the amp out of this thing, I figured I'd bring a known good turntable out here and plug it in. And obviously, this is a magnetic cartridge, and that's ceramic, because that one is way louder. But Let's see, what do we got here? South of the border. Eh, whatever. Well, that's... It's volume all the way up. Volume kinda does, or balance kinda does something. So let me do this. Oh yeah. Man, that's weird. It sure seems like that's hot. But it doesn't matter. Plugging that into either left or right, it comes out of both speakers. So I don't... I don't get it. It's got to be something screwed up in this amp. It's almost like the ground is missing or something, so there's no differential between left and right. See, it looks like we got two screws, one here and one here, and then that drops this dark piece of plywood off. Let me get this amp out of here. Maybe there are some wire nuts inside there. Alright, here's the amp, and I know I was talking to Radio TV Phononet about this thing, and he was asking if it was solid state or tube, and there you go, it's germanium. Good old germaniums, high reliability, low noise, excellent temperature coefficient. Let's see, what other kind of nice things can we say about these? The accuracy, how they're always matched. Let's see. Well, a lot of Nichicon capacitors that are probably completely and totally shot. UF at 20 volts. This thing is just loaded with capacitors. Huh. See, we've got two of these, and we've got one of these. Oh, here's the other one right here. Okay. So these are probably, these two here are probably the drivers, and these are probably the preamp. I could probably just go through and test these capacitors. I don't know if I want to do a complete recap on this or not. I've known these little 5UFs. These things go open. Are they short? These little eerie 5UF caps. Let me see if I could find a schematic on this. I wonder if that number is any good. A15515001. Let me look that up. That's interesting. The bass control is connected right in the front end. I wonder how that could not work. Unless it is working and there's just something so jacked up in the amplifier it's not passing any bass anyway. We got 200 microfarad coupling caps here. We got fives here. Well, I'm pretty sure this is going to need a complete recap. I mean, I could check them, but to do this right, since this is a customer's deal, and so these are the coupling caps right here. I bet these things are just wasted. I bet they're just completely wasted. They're like plastic. If we get this amplifier working right, this thing should absolutely sound amazing. I mean, you can see the size of the speakers in there. And I don't think you've heard this work to its full potential yet, because this thing should really easily be the life of the party. I don't know what this amp produces, probably. See, plus we only got minus 29 volts there. So this probably produces 5 watts, maybe 5 watts per channel. But you're talking about into speakers that are probably 105 dB per watt, or 105 dB at 1 watt, 1 meter. Super efficient speakers. Okay, let's have a listen to a few of these capacitors. We got our amplifier here, speaker here, phone, source of music, and this is basically in series between the amplifier and the speaker. So I think we need to dial up a little Mrs. Miller. Let's see. How about this one? There ain't no you. See my goodbye. So 200 microfarads, there should be hardly any noticeable drop across this. That one sounds okay. Let's try this one over here. See, that goes down to here. That one sounds okay. Let's give this one a shot here. So if this is like a 5 microfarad, it should sound like a tweeter only. That one's a little leaky because there's a little bit too much bass in mid-range. Let's try this one here. That one sounds okay. Let's try this one right here. That goes to ground. That one's okay. Let's give this one a shot here. That one sounds a little bit leaky. Hey, I haven't found any that are open yet. Let's try this one. That one's okay. Let's try this one. That one's okay. By okay, I mean it's not wide open. Let's give this one a shot. That one sounds okay. Let's give this one a try.
I got my man, who could ask for anything more.
This one is gone. It's wide open. And actually, it looks like it's blown out the side there. That guy's gone. That one's wide open. You know what? Let's go with something else here. Enough of the show tunes for today. Okay, this one's gone right here. 50 microfarad at 3 volts. That one is wide open. Okay, let's try this one. This one here just goes, well, we'll try this one next. See how that filters the bass off? Okay, so that one's okay. Let's try this one right here. That one's okay. And again, by okay, I mean just not wide open. Let's try this big 300 right here. That one's okay. Did I do this one right here? Let's try this one. That one's okay. All right, so this one right here is dead wide open. Let's take a look at what that does. Okay, it is C10. Let's see, C10, C7, C8. C10. It's a emitter bypass / feedback cap on the AF amp. It's not what I was looking for. I was looking for something that was kind of common between the two channels that would cause, you know, something like this one right here that's connected to the Okay, let's have a listen to these. I cut them out of the circuit, so I'll hook the black one up and then the new blue one. Okay, well, there's that one. We can hear how loud and clear that one sounds. What I'll do is I'll just parallel the new one here and you can... So this one is just totally open. All right. A new capacitor has been installed. I double checked all the capacitors again, including this one with the audio. Not that that's 100% accurate, but it's fast. I think what I'll do is I'll squirt a little lube in these pots and we'll put it back together and see what we get. Okay, it's working now. The bass, there's crosstalk in the low frequency, which is, I have a feeling is correct. I have a feeling they just run the bass through both the left and right because there's actually no stereo definition in the bass. And I know a lot of these things use the third channel where they, let me see if I could find that on here. Alright, I got the phone fed into it. Let's see what it sounds like here. This little hip-hop instrumental or something. Doesn't really matter. Oh yeah, that's what we want. sounds like I might have the speakers out of phase. It sounds like they might be canceling. Let me double check that. Yeah, now that's what I want to hear. Now, if I could just hear that with the turntable, I would be very happy. And this cartridge must have a really robust output, because I know the phone is probably close to 5 volts, and I've got the phone cranked up quite loud. So let's plug the turntable back in here. See if it sounds any better with an open capacitor replaced. Video's gone on way too long. Now you feel like such a fool for you. I sprayed some stuff in these pots. I think I need to work them a little bit. I was trying to figure out why I can't get these things to, you know, point in the right spot, and it's because they're all loose. Someone just stuck them in there, so I'm gonna use a little just contact cement and get them in the right spot. See what this does. He also said it had some mechanical problem, and I'm not sure I want to get into that. This needle seems like it has enough weight on it to... Okay. I'm trying to figure out why this thing is going in and out. As it feels so heavy to me, and I'm noticing that up here there's a screw, and I don't know if you can see it, there's like back in here, there it is, and the damn screw, there it comes, the screw is not attached to anything, it's just floating here. There's supposed to be a weight or something on the bottom of it. Huh. Maybe that would account by where the automatic thing, but what was it? Was it bolted to this thing? That sure does look like that goes up inside there. Boy, that would account. That would account by why the needle was broken, by why it's working so crappy, why it weighs so much. Huh, that would explain a lot. This thing was just laying down in the bottom of the cabinet. So I wonder where the... I can find a nut for that. Okay, I had to actually pull the turntable out to... get this weight screwed back on here, and I sure didn't get much of a bite with the screw. I guess I got enough. I put quite a bit of this red Loctite on it. I hope it doesn't come back apart. The tone arm is a featherweight now compared to the lead sinker it was before I put that weight back on. So yeah, I'm curious to see how it works now. Real curious. Let me get it back together. Well, it sure sounds a lot better with all that weight on it, but the mechanical part's still not working right. mechanical part isn't doing anything now. Holy crap, did it just work? I'm happy with this. I think it's actually kind of working pretty good now. Probably needs a new cartridge, but it sounds pretty good. I was looking at this Burt Bacharach record, and I think this needs a date with the 1200 to be ripped to MP3. I want to check out what the world needs now is love. Let's see, that's the final track on here. Let's see what this one sounds like. Told you it would annoy the neighbors. I was thinking I wanted to end this video a little bit different than most of these vintage console stereo turntable videos end. I want to end it with a little bit of different music and a little background on this. I was sound tech in a big club for a lot of years, and I inherited the head DJ's record collection when he passed away, and I pulled his record bag out of his favorite house music, which were the big hits. So I figured I would roll some of this on this thing. And I went through here and I grabbed a few of them. We'll roll a little RuPaul. We'll do some M People moving on up. We'll do Crystal Waters, 100% Pure Love. We'll do Bucket Heads, the bomb, and we'll do Night Crawlers, Push the Feeling On. Now, let me load these up on there. These have all been played over and over and over and over again in a nightclub, so they're all pretty hammered. I got quite a few here. These are were all his the top picks, the most I even got some Frankie Goes to Hollywood in here, Two Tribes. So let's load this up on here. Give this thing a break from the Burt Bacharach. Okay, here we go. We're gonna start with RuPaul. Bet this thing's never heard that before.
Tell the man with the money to come here and pay me.
A lot of these have kind of slow intros. Hey, this thing works pretty good.
kind of needs to be in a room because all the bass is coming out of the sides and it just sounds like all high end. Kind of missed it on that one, didn't it? This could be a... This is all test pressings. You can't buy any of these versions. Hey, I think we're good. Miswiring, bad capacitor, bad needle, weight missing off the thing, dirty controls, defective knobs.